Hello everybody, my name is James. Welcome back to Tiny Tina's Wonderland. And Seth has jumped off the seabed. So in the last episode, I leveled up to level 24 and got this beautiful shotgun.
The Fate Maker stops at nothing. Those shadows grin with sharpened teeth and mountains stand tall. Only the quest will prevail.
And before we go in there, I just want to quickly fire this and show people what it does. So, you see the glowy circle area? So that's the area of effect. So I pull the trigger, and after a bit of delay, fires down arrows. Now against flying enemies, yeah, it's consumes 7 ammo per shot, but it does, let's see, 138, 130 times 7 is 700, 1000 damage, plus 193, 2000 damage. So yeah, it's ammo hungry, but boy is it fun. Oh, so that green, oh yeah, because that's a level 23. So yeah, I just wanted to show that off because I actually got that in the Lost Loot Machine. Last episode.
And I'm still trying to search for a fire
weapon. Yeah. Fortunately, Seth over there hasn't had much luck with fire weapons. He's seems to have a lot of shotgun luck.
I haven't had much luck with anything I can use.
Yes, I mean, there has been fire weapons, but they've been shotguns, or they've been very crappy styles.
Just to get her story back on track, and you strummed along, happy to play your little game.
Willing to take a shot in the dark?
Sure. Legendary? Yep.
Yep.
I'm already one of the best shots in all the Wonderlands, but I want to be a legend. I've heard rumors that the Undead Army has uncovered the location of a legendary bow. I need that bow to become a true legend. Can you get it for me?
We'll see.
Certainly.
If it's good, I think
so. Might be the quad bow. Or the donkey? No, it's more like it's going to be the it's an assault rifle, so it's more like it's going to be the quadbow. Ooh.
The scroll is full of salacious tidbits and nutty goings-on within the undead celebrity world, but one note catches your eye. It says a legendary bow has been found in the Dapper Grotto.
I thought that said the Dagger Grotto. Yeah, guess we'll find out. Oh yeah, also forgot to mention that I'll level up to on level 24. Possibly, I don't know. Yeah, it's a crab ball. Should be able to pick it. Mind, that's a barrel. Yep, you did. And I ran through it.
Save me a seat on the other side.
Oh, it's a pirate.
Fly,
no. Ooh, they actually have like fighter keg monkeys. Wow, fighter keg carrying people. Oh yeah, I also brought up my melee weapon, so now you can be burst and fire once. You can fire a keg when it's laid on my face. Yeah, first fight of the crusher. Jump up, Mars. I think it's about 1,800, so that's pretty good. But yeah, I forgot these are multi-phase. It's not a boil. Okay. Thank goodness. This thing could be annoying. Oh, like a small shot or something. Yeah. I think my own boss battle just signed me. Hey, I'm not trying to be a thought like that. But see the melee weapon I'm using? I think that'd be the best thing you could use if you wanted to preserve one of these traps. Be awkward to overcook. Oh! Yeah. Yeah. Boil. Yeah. Yeah, you gotta, you know, put them in fresh water for a while. Keep changing the water, yeah. That's minus 70% spell damage. What? No, that's a minus on the top. The bottom one's over. Plus 7 projectiles, so you sacrifice damage in terms of volume. You know, where did the, you know, I got this here, Magnus of the Shine. It's mediocre, but it's not terrible. Oh, it's got an under-barrel grenade attachment. Weird. Of course, got the swallow. So you have heard of him. said, Jack Violet.
I shall not answer.
You're the lamest pirate I've ever seen. Ah, but you have seen me. Oh yeah, you're using the goblin pick. Okay, right. Like I said, though, I want to. Yeah, you should try that against the quartermaster. They're tanky AF. Spell damage, all damage dealt, Berserker Pod, nice. That's not too bad. Shield. Yeah, I get something now. Well, Berserker Pod, most status effect chance, dark magic efficiency, interesting. Oh, with the shrine piece. The scratching? Yeah. Not in the headphones though, but in like my ear. I'm gonna go and pick up the shrine piece. Well, at least go through the portal first, if you have to cut it short.
James will continue to play, so...
Can I? Won't it kick me if you disconnect?
We'll disconnect from each other, but just as they can still be in your world, so you can grind or something like that.
Oh, okay. Well, yeah, so on Seth's perspective, it's going to be a lot shorter because he's suffering from some technical issues.
Every story has an end.
Unfortunately.
Hey, yours is right now.
I love the character's voice again. Show me the squall asking gun ho. It's like you give a apprentice of Sir Hammerlock a bit too much William. Okay, guys, just melee. Blues and greens. Shabby. Ah, decent blue non-elemental Hyperius. experience. Yes, still recording, just accidentally took a screen capture there.
Oop, poisonous seaweed blocks your path. Your quest is waylaid until you can find a way past it.
Well, because my inventory is full, I'm going to now fast travel to Brightroof. Ages of retrieval capacity 1374 plus 40% wall capacity. That is a great shield for me. Only costs 35,000. I am buying that. So let me see my health. Is about that. And I swap that for you. Yep. Oh, apparently I got a bulwark as well somehow. So let's see, bunk stick, sell that. Rings, I'm good. Shields, good. Let's see, other rings. Actually sell that one. Max health, movement speed, spell damage or damage dealt. I'll take that one and keep that one.
Oh yeah, I just had an idea of something you can do.
Where's that? I could do that. So anyway, Seth is still cleaning up the machine slash waiting for it to die. And in the meantime, I am going to go and let me see with my 1608 lit luck. Try and see if I can get myself the Boyer's Breath Cryo SMG. Which unfortunately means me running all the way to the very end of the map. Yep. Thank you. enemies.
I've seen where you're headed. I don't envy you.
Not worth the... with my cryo-fire melee weapon.
I'm going to eat your brain!
Ooh, that's not too bad at skeleton. Down you go. Good to know this chest actually scales with your level, so I've gotten level 24 gear. The like chest before you go into the castle area on the way to the boss. It's the first beginning area that scales with your level. Funny skeletons, you don't stand a ghost of a chance. Ooh, and Rivula's now level 25.
Thank you.
but he did drop a Cryo Dahlia Sniper, so no damage, unfortunately, but interesting. And it's a crossbow variant as well. And in this chest here, we hear. Which has got a. Oh, interesting. A dual elemental pistol. Shock and fire. 53 times 2. Oh, it's got an underpowered taser. That's what the shock part is. Still useful. Essentially. So, I'm going to save quite now. I'm going to jump back in. And I'm going to see where exactly this spawns me. Does it spawn me halfway across the map? Yep. Spawns me in the room before. Okay. Yeah, that's one thing as well about this farm. If you... like fully quit out, you have to run all the way back, but if you just save quite, it spawns you right before. See, that was one of the I have to take the panel off down there. Oh, just filled up. Yeah, Imperial Warlock. And a Torg Dark Magic Shotgun. Inventory is
okay.
Where's the greens?
So you're fully cleaned, aside from the inside of the fan, which I'm not taking that risk. I don't have the stuff to fully go through that and really break it. That's the effect made a difference.
Yeah. I think it's time to have. Let's have an hour. So, ooh.
Oh.
Oh no, it's not the actual plug, is it, that's crackling?
I think it is.
What, the master 3-pin plug?
Yeah.
Oh dear.
You'll join our ranks soon enough.
Why did the prongs on it feel warm or bent? Because last time I heard a crackling like that, it was because there was a loose wire in the plug socket at one of the houses. The electrician had it like fully connected a wire and it was just loose enough to cause the constant crackling. Come on, we'll be like, oh yeah. Good thing that it's not. It's a big torb. Plug socket extenders like that, no idea. And oh, a legendary. Keep part of the breeze. Yeah, there we go. When did the flipping boyers breath? But, I mean, a wardrop legendary is still better than no legendary. Oh, hang on, I need to take a sip of water. Sorry for the sort of crackling there. I had to readjust my headphones. Sorry, not headphones. Sorry, headset. Blah. But also, before I go down, I need to favorite that for Seth. Let's see, still level 22, and I am just about level 24 and a half. And that arrow almost got me. So, down I go. Bomb. Okay, not the best of start. To be honest. Boom. Go over there, get the design. Come on, come here. Come on. Go down now. Yep.
Devastation
inbound. And no legendary. Oh, that's a nice assault rifle there. Nope. Oh, nothing.
So, I have a temporary replacement until I can find another one of those things. Hopefully, this won't sizzle.
Yeah, so again, just to catch people up to speed, we find what the source of the sizzling was. Turns out it was the plug socket extension torque. Uh-huh. Yeah, the main plug on it, which is very bad, because if that goes, everything connected to it could have gone up with it.
Yep.
Which includes the TV, the PS5, my phone charger, other chargers, and goodness knows what else. Yeah, and also, you know, fire issues. Come on, Rebula. Don't be a cheap spirit. This is the one weapon that I really desire. Only one. Here we go again.
Yeah, sorry about that. I don't really know what happened. Maybe water got inside the
I don't know what causes the crackling like that. Like I said, last time I heard crackling like that, it was because there was a wire in the plug socket that wasn't quite seated all the way in. But that was years ago at one of our hardware houses whenever we had the all the electric redone. But that was 24/7 constant crackling, not just sporadic like that. Anyway, here we go. Hello, Regular. mock me away. Oh yeah. Walk around the trot. Good idea. Go. Okay, and I just think we're still dying. And I'm going to kill the bubble. And I just think we're going to have to move. Lovely. Oops. And of course you move, bugger. Yes, I did. No, it's fine. It's got enough charge on it. There we go. And still nothing. Gosh darn it, Ripley. You are being one stingy so and so. Yeah, cleaning the mic. It's, I know with PC cases, you're supposed to every at least 6 months, yeah, twice a year. Yeah. No. No, the last thing you want to do is keep yourself in that way. Especially if I like or if I the controllers are put together, but you know they've got, you know, screws in the inside and you need very special machines in order to get them up and without cracking the forces.
Ooh, nice.
Yeah. Hercule, stop knocking me away. Got me something good. And then you've got just one more drop legendary. Oops, and you're teleporting. Oh. There we go. And the chest of never respawning this. Don't worry, that's fine. Take your time. I'm just farming a Ribula.
Yeah, I'll do your machine tonight or tomorrow.
Mm. Yep. Now you have three fresh meat.
Nope, still level 23. Yeah, that's one thing I'm cooking up again. And I've got one legendary. And a very decent blue, actually. Yeah, it's the Dahlia's for decent blue target sort rifle, which I might keep for myself, to be honest. because I like the whole sword gyro jet sticking in as sort of mechanic. I wouldn't say it's a gimmick, it's a mechanic.
A vial of
vitality. Yeah, I would really like that. Come on. Ooh, that was a close end there. I almost went down after defeating him. Yeah, if you're having Wi-Fi connection stability issues, yeah, a LAN cable, you know, one plugged directly into the router, you know, up to the wall, up to the floors, and then into the room. Yeah, just make sure you get one long enough. Yeah, it's got the garage below, and it's like concretified, is how I would describe it. I'll be finishing this episode once I've killed the village just one. And we'll hop back in. Yeah, I've closed the level gap a little bit. Come on, got me something good.
Wait, grab a soul guard before.
Okay. Ah. How do your companion stuff weird? That's non-elemental, yeah, I'm picking it up. Just need to collect some of the greens. So, let's just double check for what's actually. No, it's not running back.
Like
head on
to Wiggles area and then.
Oh.
If you want to do another one or something?
No, I'm going to actually head the bright of this episode, sort out my inventory, close it off, and then jump back in with you, unless you want to keep farming Ribula.
I don't mind, whatever suits you.
I mean, oh.
Can I interest you in a wee bit of violence?
Game, are you kidding me? That's a lot of money.
Yeah.
That's far too much money for that. That's very extraordinarily tempting, though.
Spend your gold in the only vending machine.
Oh, you want me to... it's only 145 damage, but this is a, like, gimmick one.
I'll pass you 4,700 gold.
Yeah, where it, increases for every crossbow, and it's a skeep pod, so... Skeep, I think, means it spawns the weird familiar...
The weird sheep familiar thing.
Yeah, that's what that does.
But, yeah, I don't really have anything good at the moment, so I'll just pass you the actual money.
Pass you the money, okay, that's fine. Well, anyway, bit of a scuffy episode, because the, plug extension star for Seth's setup decided to fizzle and almost cause a fire. So, anyway, my name's Big James. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.